أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Dear friends, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُوا مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ. So, your situation, your predicament, your suffering, your troubles, your problems won't go away if you do not do a change. And that change is within yourself. So the Muslim community was in the top, Muslim civilization was at the top, and what happened? They changed what's inside themselves. They became laxed, they neglected the duties, and they went step by step down, and they were not great anymore. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not change the condition of people, civilizations, communities like this. Their action, their deed, which will bring them down. When they deviate from God's commandments, from the deen, from the doing the lawful, avoiding the unlawful, from enjoining good, forbidding evil, and all aspects of religion. So if we want to reverse this situation, we need to change ourselves first. And we need to educate ourselves about our deen and our duties and takalif from the ibadat all the way to all aspects of fiqh and muamalat and moral values and everything. Then automatically you see the whole situation improves and become great as it used to be. This meaning of change has been quoted by many of the philosophers, many of the historic figures, all the way to the previous president who ran on this platform or motto of change. Mahatma Gandhi once said something similar, and it's been transformed to be the change you wish to see in the world. But Gandhi has said, if we could change ourselves, the tendencies in the world would also change. So it's close to the meaning of the ayah, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ. Of course, you need, we see and we complain a lot about others. Being littering, well, okay, you start with yourself, don't litter, and set the example for your children, family, to remove littering from your home, your neighborhood, the streets, etc. So the scholar said, what I am demanding of others, other people, is what I am demanding of myself. So the Arabic poet said, لا تنهى عن فعل وتأتي مثله عار عليك إذا فعلت عظيم. So the change start with yourself. There's a lady with the name of Margaret Mead, She was born in 1901 and died in 1978. She was anthropologist, and she studied primitive societies in the Pacific and in the close to Philippines, Samoa Islands, and so on, and came up with several of very nice, beautiful quotes. It's widespread on the internet, like when she said, "Never doubt that a small group of thoughtful, committed citizens can change the world. Indeed, it is the only thing that ever has." Of course, we have many, many examples in the history. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the few companions around him, they changed the world. The founding fathers, they were probably less than 55 people. They changed the world and created the greatest civilization ever known to mankind. So changes should start from the oneself by doing the things he liked to see. For example, punctuality. If you complain this friend does not come till half an hour or 1 hour late, and so you yourself be punctual. And it takes you 21 days to make of it as a habit. And it takes 90 days to make it a way of life and permanent lifestyle. So it would be a good idea, experiment on it. Let's put every 21 days one of those defects or the things we don't like, we see in our society prevalent and done by everyone, like punctuality or the lack of punctuality, and for example, lying, breaking promises, many, many of those moral values which we don't like, the lack of them we don't like in our society. So let's pick up one at a time and apply it on ourselves, make it a habit, like fixing your bed. In 21 days it become a habit and you don't feel comfortable leaving it. The same thing, after 90 days it become a lifestyle. So let's start working on ourselves to improve on our situation ethically, morally, work-wise. We should leave away laziness and complacency and the bad habits and inherited or brought with us, and shape up and be good citizens and good members of the society. May God bless you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.